thought it was really neat that biological life is able to survive so many extreme changes. No matter what environment you're in, you can explore, you can ask questions, you can turn over every stone. And I wanted to see, could we leverage that ancient resilience and throw it in the harshness of space?
Zero and lift off.
I'm Jess Atkin, and I'm a PhD student in the Soil and Crop Department at Texas A&M University. The inspiration for our work came from Earth. It came from the oldest symbiosis between fungi and plants that actually helped plants colonize Earth, land, millions of years ago. We just finished harvesting a USDA study where we studied 16 different varieties of chickpeas to see who had the most resilience and could endure this harsh climate. So we were able to put these chickpeas and microbes in this environment and see how they would interact in a near space flight-like environment. I thought that using the fungi would help us gather inaccessible nutrients and reduce toxicity, but I didn't realize how much of an impact it was going to have on the structure. And when you're dealing with regolith, NASA has made it very clear that it's not going to be a priority to use it as a substrate unless we can take it out of a hazardous category. And we were able to increase the stability to an Earth-like level, making it a bit more possible that we can use it inside of a lunar habitat. I come from a blue-collar agricultural family. I was raised by cowboys, and I'm the first one in my family to graduate from college. But what I did learn from coming from that environment was a lot of the resilience that nature has, and I was able to apply that agricultural background to this research. Science is really slow. Research is slow. Setbacks are gonna happen, and you have to have the perseverance to keep showing up every single day. And if you do that, you're going to reach your goal. A lot of really cool stuff has happened. One, we were awarded a NASA Finest Grant. I got to work at Kennedy Space Center for 5 months in the Space Crop Production Lab. I'm just as surprised as everyone else that I got here. I just think it's pretty awesome that I get to be curious and ask and answer questions every single day. That's a privilege, certainly. So I wake up excited to figure out what do I want to know and how can we figure it out. So that's what I'm really excited about.